Say hey, Yellow Jacket fans, welcome to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And Coach, an inter-county rivalry, you go over, you take care of business early. Congratulations on a 49-7 victory.
Thanks, David. You know, it was a good win for us, obviously. I thought we played very well early, and then we got a little sloppy toward late in the second quarter. But, you know, we got out to a fast start, which is what we wanted to do.
First five possessions of the ball game for the pound-and-shoot offense, five touchdowns. I'd say that's a fast start.
Well, we went in, you know, wanting to work on our passing game a little bit and, you know, kind of get Kalen going. And I thought Kalen was very sharp early, and then he wasn't so sharp. But Kalen is getting better each game. And, you know, I thought our receivers played well last night, too. I thought they caught the ball well for the most part. And offensive line continues to play well for us. And I can't say enough about the defense there. They're playing very well for us.
He touched it off, folks, and we're going to go through them a little bit here one at a time. Last week, Kalen was very good in his decision-making on the fakes. Last night, I thought that was as comfortable as I'd seen him passing the ball.
Yeah, I thought he was comfortable, especially early. You know, he made some good deep throws for touchdowns.
Yes.
And, you know, we felt like, if you think about our game last week, we threw a bunch of screens.
Yes.
So I think that was Gordon Central's game plan to try to stop our screens. And, you know, when we saw that, we felt like we had to throw the deep ball, and I think we were very successful throwing the deep ball last night.
Robbie's Raiders, the offensive line, did an outstanding job and able to pound and shoot offense to be varied. So if you didn't hit the long pass, you were able to run the ball. The guys did a good job there. The defense, the black shirt defense of Coach Hobb the Elder, by the way, Mike Davis runs the offense. Coach Hobb the Elder's defense was just outstanding. Gave up 7 points in a tough field. They had 30 yards they had to protect. Another good game by them.
Yeah, our defense continues to play very well. I think we're very sound on that side of the ball, and the kids play hard, and they read their keys, and they go where they're supposed to go, and they make tackles. And I'm real pleased with the way the defense is playing. Special team-wise, we got to get – I thought Darwin was good last night.
Yes, very good.
Kicking the football. We decided to, you know, work on our deep kick, and he kicked it deep all night long, which I thought was good. Alex continues to kick extra points well, and Drew McCracken's a tremendous snapper. You know, we made some hiccups, I guess you'd say, on our punt return team, but we'll get that. That's one thing we've got to get corrected this week.
I think that's just a confidence issue.
Yeah, it is. It's all about confidence.
Yes.
If you really think about catching punts, it's probably one of the hardest things to do in the game. And but we've got to make better decisions, and we'll get on the board Sunday afternoon, and we'll discuss our punt return situation.
Yeah, and that'll pick up. Alex Flores is perfect this season, extra points, 13 for 13. Darwin Lom kicking the ball straight down the field to the goal line. He got a couple touchbacks last night. I think Alex even picked up another touchback. They both have two on the season. We've been spoiled with our snappers throughout the years, the Fricks brothers, Ty and Trent. Coach, I don't think the snap from Drew McCracken gets 6 inches off the ground. The hardest thing to do on a football field, I think, is to return punts. I think the next most difficult thing is to catch a Drew McCracken snap, and Thomas Lester catches those bullets. I mean, he gets back there so fast, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, you know, it's a blessing to have a good snapper, and Drew's working very hard, and I hope he's going to have the opportunity to be a deep snapper at the next level. We're working very hard at that, but he's very good at deep snapping. Of course, he's worked very hard at what he's doing, and, you know, we punted one time last night. And I think it was a 45-yard punt out of our own end zone. So that was good to see as well.
Yeah, just all facets of the game were really good. Like you said, you got off to a very, very fast start. And sometimes when you get a big lead like that, sometimes your focus wavers just a little bit. But regardless, you got a lot of guys into the game. I don't know if you got all 90-plus in, but you worked hard with a running clock in the fourth quarter to get them all in.
Yeah, we played a lot of kids last night. You know, we wanted to play them a little more than we did, but we talked about that at halftime. We wanted the ones to go one more series.
Yes.
Defensively and then offensively, we wanted to feel good about, you know, get another score and then get them out. So, but I thought our young kids, when they went in there, they did extremely well.
I thought they did too. Folks, we're going to pause and we're going to come back and take a look at the first half highlights. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Welcome back to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Coach, It wasn't really hot, but golly, was the humidity stifling.
Yeah, it was. I thought the humidity was very difficult to deal with, especially, you know, we kept watching the weather. I thought it was going to be one of those nights where we're going to have delays, and I think some people in our area did have some delays, but it was discussed in the fourth quarter, you know, because some of our...
A lot of games throughout the entire state of Georgia, as well as locally, were delayed with lightning and rain. It was just one a bad situation. We dodged a bullet. Captains for tonight's game.
You got J.R. McBrayer. You got Drew McCracken. I can't see the other number.
Chaz
Moss and Esteban Valadares.
There you go. Yeah. And as always, the playing surface at Gordon Central is in good shape.
Yeah, it was. You know, I talked to Coach Humphreys before the game, and, you know, he wished they had got it cut Wednesday, but they were worried about the rain. But it was in really, really good shape.
Yeah, good condition. You're now averaging 34 and 7/10 points a game and only giving up 9 points a game. Gordon Central wins the toss. They defer to the second half, so we'll be receiving to start things off. And, boy, did we start things off. That was your 10th consecutive regular season victory, your 101st consecutive region victory. 101, that's amazing.
That is pretty amazing.
Yes, it is. Unbelievable. All right, they do a sky kick, and we're going to answer this very quickly. Watch number 28, Cole Jackson, folks.
Yeah, I thought we had a good plan to do a pooch kick, and we had everybody blocked up, and it was a good run by Cole getting it down to about the 35-yard line.
Yeah, the kicker doesn't make that tackle. It's six. It's to the house. I was kidding his parents before the game. I said, well, you're going to have to watch Cole quickly because he's not going to be in there a whole lot.
And
he got things off quickly, and he was a star of the first play of the game, obviously. Go deep, and one play, touchdown. And that goes from Kalen Riley to Chaz Moss, our first throwing, receiving touchdown of the season.
Yep, and that's, that's unusual for us.
One of the goals.
Yeah,
usually it's the other way around.
Yeah, we wanted to work on our passing game, and we talked about throwing the deep ball early, and, you know, obviously it was successful. We knew they'd be probably sitting on our screens after last week.
I talked to Coach Humphreys after the game, and he said, we weren't going to let respectfully, let them dink and dunk us down the field. He says, we took away the screens. He says, but that opens up other things.
Right.
He says, give Coach credit, he found those other things. Darwin Lahm just puts another bomb down the field. And
that's a perfect kick there. Yeah. We just, on the backside, we lost our contain. That's something we've got to work on.
Yeah, and give Gordon Central credit for being able to get outside of it. But
you
want two receivers fighting each other for the ball at the goal line.
Exactly.
At the numbers.
Yep. They got good field position here to 41-yard line, and we didn't do anything different defensively. We just want our kids to line up and play hard and know where they're going and know what they're doing. And good pick here by Baylen Spector, and it's a big play, obviously, on the first play defensively.
Runs the tip drill. Calhoun's been on the field for two plays. You're going to see a block and a back penalty flag that's going to back us up from the 8 or 9 yard line where Baylen got the ball down to, so we're going to start a little deeper. But offensively, we run one play, easy for me to say. We have 7 points. They run one play. We've got the ball back. We won the turnover battle last night, 3-2. Give it to Cole Jackson. In, out, down the sideline he goes, and he does get a good positive gain out of it.
Good job by Cole. Good job up front, blocking on his own play.
7 yard gain on that, two receivers left and two right. Empty backfield for Kalen. Give it to Bryson Bushong. You said you were going to get him more carries.
Yeah, we got to find ways to get Bryson the ball a little bit, and that's a little no-back package we put in for him this week. And Bryson's very talented. We just got to find ways to get him the ball.
Well, you know, you're kind of like the University of Georgia. Your running backs are deep. That's Cole Jackson banging over the right guard, cut back to the left, and we're inside the 10-yard line where it's first and goal at the 9. Or third down, I'm sorry, at the 9. Kalen just keeps on pushing, and they can't stop the 200-pounder. He gets into the end zone for a rushing touchdown.
That's a good hard run by Kalen. He yards after contact, they hit him about the 6-yard line or 5-yard line, and he kept moving his feet and got in the end zone.
Little yak yards. Snap's good from Drew. The hold's good by Thomas. And then the kick is true by Alex. We lead 14-0.
Again, we wanted a quick start, and I think that's what we got.
Yeah, you know, we've run 5 offensive plays. We have 14 points. We've run 1 defensive play, and we got a turnover. And that's a pretty fast start, Coach. Kick deep down inside the hash. It is a true touchback.
And I think once Darwin kicks the ball more, you know, this is brand new to Darwin. If he'd been with us for 4 years, I'm telling him where he'd be kicking it. But
I'll tell you what he'd be doing. There'd be a lot of football coaches fighting over him at universities.
The more he does it, the better he's going to get, I think.
Yeah, he's been kicking the circle sphere. Now he's got the oblong one, and he's doing both of them really well. Good defense, like you said, not doing anything extraordinary. We seem like we blitzed Gyra from the weak side a lot tonight.
I think we did. Gyro's a very good football player, and he's a good blitzer, as well as just, you know, from a regular position. He's very smart, very heady kid. He gets everybody lined up.
We got a good push from the defensive front, the front three, Landon Rice, Blaine Anderson, and in the middle, Dustin Harris. Landon's going to pick up a couple deflections, and there goes Gyra in, and there's the first deflection by Landon, and we're just in the quarterback's face, and to the quarterback's credit, Shy Williams, he didn't back off all night because
pretty good. I really did. I was impressed with their quarterback.
They're going to punt. This is Bailey Widow. He gets a lot of practice at this. Gets a good roll. A good decision by Chaz not to pick that up on the first one, and then we get a little antsy. You're not allowed to advance a bouncing punt, so they do get the fumble recovery off the muffed punt.
Yeah, it was probably a good decision to pick it up. And, you know, you don't need to pick it up on a short hop, though. You know, it's kind of like baseball. You know, let's get a Sunday hop before we pick it up back there.
Good hard run by Gordon Central's Devontae Jenkins. And then you can see all the gold hats. We're wearing white shirts, but we're still the black shirt defense. I like this color combination, gold, white, and black.
Well, we put on the black pants because we thought it might be raining. It's harder to clean them Vegas gold pants.
Folks, I walk into the locker room and those washers and dryers are gone 5 days a week. Pass down and out with good coverage by Baylen Spector is incomplete.
They called pass interference. I didn't think that was a very good call. But
The side judge on the Gordon Central bench had a really mediocre night.
Mediocre night.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a ticky-tack. There's a penalty they call later on against Gordon Central by him, and it wasn't a penalty either, I don't think. They run over the right guard. We're hitting a lot of people, putting a lot of pressure. And like you said, we didn't do anything extraordinary, but the defense just kind of lined up and played it straight, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
Shy Williams drops back. He's going to try to hit the guy over the middle. And I'll tell you what, Coach, that's a good catch.
That was a good throw and a good catch. And, you know, we didn't have bad coverage. We just got to make a play on the ball.
Yeah, I think the receiver was just a tad more aggressive going to the ball than the DB was. Good snap, good kick as Aguilar gets the extra point. And right now, the home side of the crowd at Ratner Stadium's going nuts because it's only 14-7. So, you know, it's good for them. And I'm like you, I think we talked off camera. I think this team's a little bit better than what they were last year, don't you?
Yeah, I think they're going to win a couple of games, I believe.
Oh, yeah.
I really do. Good hard running by Cole.
I'll tell you what, Colts found him a spot on the kickoff return team as well as running back, Yeah, he gets the pads low. Good rush. We were looking for.
Now we were throwing a screen there, and they shut down our screens. Now, we get back to our screens a little bit later in the game, but early they were all over them, so we didn't throw as many. Run up. I think they're offsides here. I think we get 5 more yards.
You're right. There's going to be offsides against, against Gordon Central.
I was worried about Kalen here. Kalen got hurt on that last play a little bit, and good news, he just got stepped on. I know that's not good news, but it's better than some news.
Yeah, and once again, they jumped the tunnel screen.
Jumped the screen again. That's a good job by Kalen, getting some good yardage.
He gets across midfield. So that's a 13-yard gain. Yeah, you look at what could happen in an injury, and getting stepped on is a minor. Olico Dennis, I mean, folks, he finds a hole, and shoestring tackle from behind, or he's to the house.
That was a good job up front and good run by Olico.
Robbie's Raiders doing a great job as Drew McIntyre on the right-hand side, as well as Austin Stout, Spencer Cross anchoring in the middle on the left side, guard to tackle. It is Truett Moss and Jack DeFore. And look, nice cut. Puts his shoulders down, and I'm proud of him for running north-south.
Yeah. Kalen had to go out of the game a little while, and Balin comes in. I thought Balin did a good job as a backup here, doing what he's coached to do. And good run by Alico.
One cut to the right.
Up front.
Yeah, one cut to the right, and he's in the end zone. That's quick. Yeah, Robbie's Raiders are just doing an outstanding job. The guys are blocking really well. There were some big holes in there. Drew McCracken snapping. Thomas Lester holding. Alex Flores with the 21st point of the game, and Alex continues to be perfect in the extra point department. 5:03 left.
Yeah, Alex does, you know, going into the season, we really didn't know who our kicker was going to be because we feel like we got about four or five good ones. You know, we got Darwin and you got Gabriel Garcia, that both those kids just came out and they're talented on the soccer field and they can kick the ball too. But Alex has been with us pretty much the whole time and he's more consistent, I'd say.
Yeah, and Juan Palmer, and the left-footed kicker, is right behind Alex pushing him because Juan's pretty consistent too.
Yeah, Juan's just a 10th grader, so he's got he kicks on the JV force.
Good kickoff down to the goal line. They get it out to the 20, which is just like a touchback. So they have 80 yards to go, Coach. Oh, my goodness. Will Conley in there busting things up. And then the rest of the defense. I tell you what, Coach. I watch you guys run sprints, and I can barely hear Will Conley's feet hit the ground. I know the opposing team can't hear him coming in. All of a sudden, it's boom.
Yeah, Will is, he's a three-year starter there.
Yes.
And he's very coachable. He's solid. He does what he's coached to do, and he makes plays.
And did we mention he does it really well?
Yes.
Yeah. Little screen out here on the right-hand side. It's covered up. Baylen Spector starting at cornerback with Kobe Reynolds starting at safety. I thought both of them handled themselves well in their different starting roles.
Yeah, you know, Baylen's very versatile, I guess you say. He can play receiver and play safety, play corner, and obviously he's a backup quarterback. So,
which he did in this entire game.
He's a very important part of our football team. And then Carson Brown, he plays some corner. He was banged up a little during the week, so we started Baylen at corner and Kobe at free safety. Kobe continues to get better for us at free.
Yes. His first start, he's played there throughout the season, coming off a leg injury. Low snap, Whittle does a good job of fielding it, short hopped it, kicks it down the field, and he just nailed this punt.
There's Jarrett Carden making a good decision picking it up because he had no pressure. I mean, the kid punts it, you know, he's punted some 25 yards and 28 yards, and he decides to punt that one 50. So we really don't know where to put the return guy.
Yeah, I noticed that during the game. Jarrett or Chaz are looking over the sideline. They're backing up five, moving forward five, and it's tough. This is a nice route, nice pass. And by the way, folks, that's your snapper, Drew McCracken. They're going to call a helmet-to-helmet hit there. And
That was a good execution there on the stick route by Kalen and Drew. Drew's our deep snapper, but he also plays a lot of wide receiver for us.
And does a good job there. Shotgun formation. Cole Jackson providing protection on the right, and we're looking up there, and there's Carson Brown. That takes care of the nicks and the bumps and the bruises when you get a long touchdown.
Good protection, good throw on the post route.
That's Carson's first touchdown reception of the season. That's Kalen's second touchdown pass. And this is getting to be automatic, and I don't want to get people to think lightly of it. Look at that snap. I mean, low, on the tee, boom, through the upright.
Yep. And like I said, you don't really think about snappers until you don't have one. Then you start thinking about it a bunch.
Yeah, you just go back to last week's game. The punt snap was okay. The extra point snap was just terrible. Mm-hmm. Kick down the field, right down to about the 7-yard line.
There's Bryson Bushon making a play. I tell you, Bryson Bushon is—he's a tough kid. He can run. He'd run through a brick wall if you ask him to. He's got two bad shoulders.
And when he gets there, he's angry.
Yeah.
I was kidding with his parents last night, and I said he's fairly intense. His mom says, "Well, is that what it is?" I said, "Yeah." All right, we're going to back him up. They run a sweep to the right, kind of like a jet sweep, and there's just no place to go, folks.
I thought that was a good play by Tristan Fuller, number 32.
Yeah.
Our front three is pretty physical up there with Landon and Dustin and Blaine Anderson. Blaine Anderson, you know, he weighs probably 240, but I tell you, he plays extremely hard. And if you'll just isolate on him in a game, he's wide open every snap.
And he arrives with a bad attitude. Yeah, he gets the job done. And the Huntsman, Dustin, just runs left to right. And of course, you got big Landon Rice, Thor on the left end. There, we got pressure once again on the quarterback. Good job of the quarterback sticking in there. Receiver runs a nice route. They get a completion. I mean, this quarterback was dodging arms and helmets and jerseys all night long.
They threw that little out route all night long. I think that was their game plan. You know, throw. I know they didn't feel like they could run it on us, so I think they threw it more than they normally do.
This young man does a good job running the ball. I think that's Dakota number 15. Reminds me of the Dalton running back,
mm-hmm,
the same
sure
build.
Does, yep.
Makes the quick cuts, the spin cuts in the hole. Yeah, they tried to draw us offside.
And they did.
Yeah, they got us. Little 5-yard penalty. We're going to mark off that 5. Yeah, like we said, the humidity never lessened up the whole night. I'm just shocked after the first 3 weeks that there hasn't been tons of cramping. So kudos to all the coaches in the area. They've done a good job getting your kids ready.
Yeah, I agree. I think our conditioning has really paid off.
Coming in is Austin Bennett. The running back was suspended. The back was down. That's not a fumble, but God, that's the kind of thing where Austin's just going to bend you over, and he did. Everybody survived healthy. Good hit. Good lick. Oh, yeah. You think you're getting away from Dustin Harris. I got a hold of your jersey. You're going down.
Good job by Dustin Harris. Again, Dustin's a 3-year starter for us in there at nose guard. He's one of the better nose guards we've had here since I've been here. He's a very, very good player, strong and quick. Yeah. We got to get him at the next level somehow.
Somebody has to pay attention.
Yes.
Yeah, they're missing the boat. Second quarter's going to begin. We're up 28-7. Gordon Central puts the ball in the air, and once again, Landon Rice puts his big paw up there, number 44, and deflects that to the ground. Going to bring up a punting situation. So Whittle is going to put his foot into it. It's going to be a short punt, and then we're going to try to field it. And we put a good rush on it that time.
Yeah, we tried to block that one. That's the first one we tried to block, and again, we just got to make better decisions.
I know 21.
He'll be fine. He's a great kid and hard worker. And
yes.
Nobody works harder than he does. It's all about it. It's in his mind now. Like you said, it's all about confidence.
Yeah, you'll get that straightened around. I have all the confidence in the world. Tristan Fuller busting up plays on previous plays. Now he gets a tackle on the backfield. Tackle for a loss. So they're going to have the ball. They started at our 33-yard line. They said... I think I gave him a half-yard loss in the stat sheet so he could get a TFL. All right, shotgun formation. Empty backfield for them except for the H-back, who's behind the left tackle, and they move. 5-yard penalty.
Yeah, they've done that some, so we were prepared for that little no-back set except for the H-back being in there.
Yes. Regular shotgun formation, almost a pistol set with the running back behind the quarterback a little bit. We got pressure on him, and I'll tell you what, Tristan Fuller out there raking the arms and knocking that pass out.
That was good coverage. Good job by Tristan replacing Will, because Will was, I think he was stunting there.
Yes.
Here's their no back look. Put pressure on the quarterback. Good job by Jira. That was a big hit in the secondary. You can't really see, but good job by Baylor.
That was a good hit. Carson got a good lick in there. And I tell you what, the nice thing about Jira, he kept that hit low so you don't get that helmet-to-helmet on the quarterback, because he got there just after the quarterback had released it. This is a nice fair catch under a lot of pressure.
That was a good job by Jarrett. You know, the rule is put your heels on the 10-yard line and don't back up, and I think he caught it right at the 10.
Right at the 10. Kalen comes out. Beautiful low catch by Ethan Woodard. He went down by the shins and used his fingertips. 1st and 10.
That was a good catch by Ethan. I think if Kalen hits him in stride, I think we got a chance to go 90 yards there. But that was a great catch by Ethan.
We'll run on the left-hand side behind Spencer, Truett, and Jack. Back over the middle we go. Now we're finding Malik Lawrence. Another little stick or curl.
A little stick route in there. Good throw by Kalen. Good route.
We're at the 49-yard line, or 49, first and 10.
This is a great job by Kalen.
Good check down to what? He's third receiver?
Yep, finding his check down. You know, we don't do that very often, and I was glad to see Kalen do that.
And when you get number four in the open field, he thought the first guy who was going to hit him was the official, so yep. He had to get around him first. Overdrive, putting in an overdrive, getting down the field. And folks, I know he's quick and he's got great vision, but he's got some strength.
Yes, he does. Good run by Kalen. Good blocking on the sweep there. Got it on the 1 yard line.
Did I mention he's getting north south?
Yes.
Yeah, there you go. Good job by the left side of the line. Good job by the right side of the line. Cole Jackson is getting it in the end zone. And Cole picking up his third touchdown of the season.
That was a very good drive by our offense. We went 90 yards. Last week we went 99 yards, and this week we'll go 90. So.
And you had an 80-yard drive last week, too.
Mm-hmm. I think the check down there was a big play by Kalen and Olico.
Yeah, huge. Extra points good, and we lead 35-7 with 8:37 left in the first half. And there's probably some fans in the stands thinking, all right, get another one, and coach is going to start substituting. We're going to get a lot of players in.
But that's what the plan was. And from here on out, I think we get a little sloppy offensively.
Down to the 4 yard line? Yeah. We
do. Good coverage. You just got to make the tackle. There's Bryson Bush on a tackle again.
I think if you just close your eyes and say on a kickoff return, 14 makes a tackle, you're going to be right about 75% of the time. They run a sweep. Well, it's supposed to be off right tackle. They try to get it outside. Oh, my golly. It's a good thing Jairo Wilson missed him. Tristan Fuller at the bottom on that tackle. That was a scud missile going
through. Yes, it was.
Iron Mike was going to lower him. And, you know, they run this down and out, an acute angle. You know, they run that nice. They obviously practice that a lot.
Yes,
it's good
do.
Timing.
They put some pressure on your drop player with all that stuff they're doing, and they do a good job with it. I think that was their plan.
But we're going to take these four
good
and five.
Job by, yeah, good job by Balin.
Yeah, he's all over the receivers.
They called it a catch, and then one referee came in and said it was no catch.
That was the side judge I mentioned earlier.
Yeah.
He's catching up to the speed of the game. Whittle puts his foot in. This is a low punt, and my goodness, does it roll. I mean, that ball went about 15, 18 yards in the air, ends up down at our 40-yard line.
I'll tell you, the tough deal is you don't know where it's going. You know, he punted 150 and 120, 115. And
keeps you guessing.
Yep.
Kalen at quarterback, hands off to Cole Jackson. Nice job, nice stunt job. Good job by their defensive lineman to get in there.
Yeah, they switched the front up on us, and we weren't very smart up front, but it's a good job by their defensive front.
Mental lapse. Looking down the middle of the field, and we hit Chaz Moss. Missing.
We make that throw, and it's, you know, we're getting them out. It's 42-7, and we can't miss that throw in big games. You can't miss touchdown throws.
Yeah, he was wide open. Split that two deep defense perfectly. Kalen turned to find the screen, can't find it, checks down, and he scrambles and gets it up to about the 48-yard line. It is fourth down. We run a play over right tackle, and they did a good job of stuffing it. We didn't get the surge that time on the right side like we wanted to. It's going to be first and 10 for Gordon Central. Shotgun formation. They have two receivers right, two left, and pretty much what you call an empty set backfield except for the H back to the right-hand side. Quarterback drops straight back. There's that down and out there, and we got a hold of his jersey. He pulls away and gets a good positive gain on it, but it's the kind of thing we're keeping him in front of us.
Yeah, they're doing a good job throwing a little attacking the flats on both sides of the field.
42 wants to run it to the right-hand side, and Will commonly spun him around like a top, and then the rest of the defense catches up. It's a good thing he stepped to the left because Will was going to plant 18 right through his sternum.
This is a good stop right here. It's third about a foot.
Ooh! Yeah, you're right. It's third and foot, and they actually lose yardage. It becomes fourth and one.
Yep. Real surprised. Did they wind up punting this or go for it?
Is this where they take a timeout and then go to the punt?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm trying to get caught up on my sheet, and they look to the sideline.
Yeah, I was real surprised they punted this, but
Yeah, they're going to take a timeout. And when they come out of the timeout, they're going to go into punt formation. I was surprised, too. I'm thinking, you know, it's 35-7. What do you got to lose? Your 40-yard line. Go for it. But everybody makes the decision they got to make. They want to pin us down deep, and you know what? They're going to pin us down deep.
Yeah, we didn't even have a return guy because we were playing fake, playing safe. And so he punted down to the 5.
Good decision, huh?
Yep.
So it works out really well for them.
Come out the gate, throw it deep there, and almost had it. Well, it was close.
Yeah. Tried to run a streak down the right sideline, and they do a good job on our running play, stop Olico near or at the line of scrimmage or a half-yard loss.
I think this is the worst series of the night.
Yes,
it is. This is where it starts going south.
Yeah, we weren't real proficient on this series. And it may have started with the fourth down play.
Yeah.
In the previous series. We got Drew McCracken running a skinny post or whatever you call it over the middle, and he was wide open.
Yep.
We're punting from our 4-yard line. Great snap, of course. Darwin puts a good punt. His one punt of the night, Coach, he gets a 45-yarder.
Yep. I tell you, if you can punt out your own end zone and get it to midfield, you're doing pretty good.
Job well done.
I thought that was a good job by Darwin.
Yeah. They take over first and 10 at the 50. Pump fake, throw a little down and out here, and that is incomplete, and the side judge has caught up with the speed of the game. Two receivers left, one right. They run a little option. Delayed draw.
Yep.
Yeah. Left, it's snuffed down. Blaine Anderson, Dustin Harris, the linebackers.
Now they go work in the flats again, and that's better coverage by, who was that, Will or Thomas?
Now, I think that was Will on that one.
Porson punt the football. So it's a good stand by our defense.
Too good, yeah.
They had good field position at midfield, and here goes another punt. You know, this one goes about 10 yards.
Yeah. I think I ended calling him an 18-yard punt. But anyway, you called timeout, and you're trying to preserve time on the clock. We've got it with 1:13 left. We have it at our 31.
Well, this is a perfect time to work your 2-minute O, and that's mainly why I call timeout, because, you know, there's nothing like game situations. So we're in 2-minute O, and good throw by Kalen. We just got to catch the ball right there, Malik.
Well, when we caught it, we just got to secure it.
Yep.
Yeah. So the officials come up hurriedly and say that is an incomplete pass. It's one of those plays, if we were doing college, we'd be in a 10-minute video review.
We throw a screen out here, finally got one of our screens going, getting 9 yards, so it's 3rd and 1.
Good blocking by the left side of the line with Jack DeFore and Truett Moss and Spencer Cross at center. Roll to the right-hand side, and I think the forward momentum of the quarterback just got the pass going too long.
It's 4th down. We got another screen call. We got a big play, but the receiver falls down. He slips. But it's a good job by Kalen getting the first down.
So we get that first down, and we're down to about, is it under 20 seconds on the clock?
Yeah, about 22.
Okay, 22.
We clock it right here to stop the clock.
Yeah, that's what we do. Starts the clock, and you're right. We do intentionally ground it. Yeah, that was a nice scramble by Kalen.
Mm-hmm.
People forget how big and strong he is. He's 6'4", and he's a solid 200 pounds. Oh, now he's going to scramble back to the left-hand side. I'm surprised we did a good job of not getting a hold call. Down the field, and great defensive play by Gordon.
Yeah, Central. We almost had it. That, you know, that's what we want Kalen to do sometimes. You know, he's going to have to make plays and
improvise.
He does a good job with that. We just try to throw it deep here and almost catch it.
Oh, Landon Rice had his hands on his fingertips on the ball, and he almost pulled it in. I don't know if they'd have been able to stop the big train if he'd have caught that. He may have made it to the house. Pretty good first half. I know it didn't end the way proficiency-wise that you wanted, but hey, first 5 touches offensively, you get a touchdown. First touch defensively, or second play on defensively, you get a pick. It's 35-7.5. You're mostly satisfied.
Yeah, pretty much satisfied. But you know, we'd obviously like to be up 42-7. That way, we can get everybody out of the game. But you know, it is good teaching situations. That's for sure. Because the last half of the second quarter, there's a lot of things I saw on tape that we can show them and say this is what we can't do or can do. And as we get deeper in the season.
Yes. Folks, just sit back in that Barker Lounger and relax. You're going to watch the best doggone band in the land, Pride of Georgia's Northland, the Yellow Jacket Marching Band, 272 strong, led by Michael Clark and assisted by Larry Brown. They're going to put on a fantastic halftime show. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the second half. Football fans, Yellow Jackets with a 35-7 lead. And Todd Halbert and I were guessing in the press box. I'm thinking the ones are going to play one or two more series.
Yeah, we wanted to get to ones one more series. We wanted to stop them because we were obviously kicking off, stop them three and out, and then get to offense and go score and then go from there. And that was the plan, and it worked.
Yes, it did. Kick it right down at
perfect,
the numbers.
Perfect kick. And this is great coverage by, there's Rhett Rogers, number 84. A lot of white shirts on that one.
Yeah, Rhett got, number 84 got down the field quick. Got him backed up at the 5-yard line, and folks, there's no place to go. Carson Brown and the wide receiver having a little discussion after the play.
They were talking about where they were going to eat after the game.
I think so.
This could have been called a safety, the way I look at it. But
well, a charitable decision by the referee. So, yeah. And you watch a referee at the end of the game, the head referee. He does a good job of managing the clock.
Oh, Will almost had a pick six.
He was hustling to get into coverage, and if he looked a nanosecond earlier, it was to the house. They're punting. I thought he was going to step out of bounds for a safety. By golly, he did step forward, and the referee was watching his foot. Good decision by Jared Carden, because here's a 25-yard punt.
Yep, now we got it on the 30-yard line, and it don't take us long to score.
No, it doesn't. Roll to the right-hand side, pump fake. He's going to tuck it. Kalen is. Picks up 2 yards, so it's going to bring up second down from there, 28.
We had a miscommunication there. We should have been running one play, and we ran another.
Well, you know.
Good job on the stick route.
New terminology, folks. That's Drew McCracken getting people off of him. I call it a curl. Coach calls it a stick route, so I'll have to learn to call it a stick. All right, here we go. Cole Jackson through the left side, back to the right, breaks two more tackles, puts a leg right through the chest of a tackler, and into the end zone he goes with his fourth rushing touchdown of the season, second one tonight.
That's one of the better runs Cole's made this year. He is a very, very tough kid.
Coach, I think we've already accumulated at least the top five of his best runs of the season so far. I'll tell you what, he gets the pads low and gets the knees high. Drew McCracken snapping, Thomas Lester holding, and Alex Flores continues to be perfect. 42-7, mission accomplished, 9:25.
Yeah, got what we wanted. Yeah. And, took care of business. Now we start substituting, getting a lot of people. And we go with our twos right here on defense.
Ball's teed up here on the near hash. Kick it right down the hash. Just a little bit inside at the numbers, and the receiver lets it go into the end zone for a touchback.
I don't think that receiver wanted to catch it.
Well, not after what happened last time. Yeah. You got to start at the 20, why catch that and get beat up at the 5? All right, here we go. Two receivers left, two right. Yeah, we do have number twos in on the field and a little.
There's Jordan Tao and East and Trotter making the tackle, number 10 and number 57. Both those kids are juniors, very good players.
Shy Williams gets the play from the sideline and mostly an empty set backfield. Yeah, we got Malik Lawrence playing corner down here, don't we? Little down and out or stop route or a curl on the right-hand side, completed.
Yep, third and one, or third and a foot. Let's see what we do here. I can't remember.
I can't believe they didn't give him a first down on that spot.
Yep.
I thought they could have spotted that ball at the 30 and then it's a first down.
Oh,
ooh,
yeah.
Goodness gracious. That is Mr. East making him pay for the bobble.
Yeah, Christian East, number 47. He's not big as a minute, but I'll tell you, he's very, very physical for his size.
He hits you, it feels like an hour went by. Your life will flash in front of your eyes. A good press coverage up top here.
Yeah, we're doing a little bit of that, and then bailing. Fumble there.
A little delay draw, and fortunately for Gordon Seth, they hopped on. 57 was there looking at it. That's Easton Trotter.
Easton Trotter up front. We got Grayson Tilly, number 79. Oscar Valadares, not Oscar, that's his brother. Esteban Valadares, 69. And I think we got J.R. McBrayer up top, number 51.
That pass was incomplete. Quarterback almost made a sensational throw and a sensational grab because we had that defense to
Yes, we did. That was a good throw.
We had it covered under and over the top. We put a semi-rush on, and here's a low punt that hits on the ground and rolls, and we did the right thing by letting it get away from us, and we're going to take over at our 18. 6:31 left in the third quarter. We lead 42-7.
Got Baylen in the game, and we're in the wrong formation there.
Yeah, illegal procedure. They line up wrong. 5-yard penalty. We'd be starting from the 13. Actually, we started from the 19. They mark it back to the 14. Give it to Mr. Bushong over left side.
He's a hard runner. He's a tough kid, I tell you. Up front, we got Matthew Mullinak snapping. We got Grayson Tilley in the game. Blake Garland, number 60. 51 is J.R. McBrayer. And I think the other guard is Esteban Valadares, if I'm not mistaken. Good job on Baylen getting the first down here. It was third and about two.
Was that a read or did he take the high snap?
It was a read.
Okay. Well, he made the right decision. Mm-hmm. And you notice how quick he got down the sidelines.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
When he planted that outside foot, that left foot, he was gone. This is a nice one.
Throw the screen out here to Jarrett Carden. And, you know, we get 7 yards. Didn't block it great, but still 7 yards.
Does he weigh 140 pounds?
Soaking wet.
I tell you what, he's quick and he does a good job. He's got good hands. He's tough. Baylen running to the right-hand side, and please get down to the ground, huh?
That was
Bryson.
Bryson.
I'm sorry, yeah, Bryson. Well, how hard could he hit you if he had good shoulders?
Yeah, I tell you, he's got two bad shoulders, that's for sure. He's got a brace. He wears a double shoulder brace.
Really?
Yeah.
He just grins after the game.
Yeah.
Because he knows he's giving out some early Christmas presents called hard licks. There he is, banging over left side of the second Robbie Raider, the young Robbie Raiders. Robbie's Raiders. Good play fake, splits three tacklers, gets positive yards.
Mm-hmm. Third and about five.
We are at their 34-yard line. I'm going to put Bryson on the left-hand side. They're coming with a blitz up our offense's left. Scrambling, and I don't know how much he would have gotten, but the humid turf got him.
Yeah.
Turf
fourth marks. Down, I believe.
It is. From there, 38.
We got him open. We just got to make the throw.
Yeah.
Baylen doesn't get a whole lot of work at quarterback. When he does, you know, it's base stuff. He plays so many positions that it's hard to get all his reps at quarterback. They run a little wheel route, and that's a good throw.
Yes, and 22, Malik Lawrence was getting ready to drop the hammer. Yeah, you got to be careful with that wheel route. Your receiver can get exposed quickly. That's a nice job out there by number.
That's Colby Reynolds and Jordan Tao, number 10. Yeah. Colby makes the tackle for a loss from the free safety position.
Well, Jordan extended that play by making the runner go around the block. Oh, look out.
There's Connor Akeridge with a sack, number 33. Good play by Connor.
Connor's going to show up again later in this game.
That's a good job by our two defense, forcing them to punt the football.
Bailey Whittle with the snap, puts his foot into the ball. More of a traditional punt and a fair catch at our 39-yard line. There's 1:23 left in the third quarter. We're up 42-7. Yeah, Baylen does a nice little down and out here to the receiver.
That was Jarrett. Good catch.
And Jarrett's all over the place. Does a good job. Bushong, right guard. Positive yards up near the first down marker. Third and short, one. Tempted just to hand it to him again, aren't you?
Mm-hmm. And we do. And we get stuffed.
We get stuffed the line. They came with a blitz.
Yep.
Third quarter comes to a close. We're going to have a running clock in the fourth quarter, so we're going to have to work quick.
Yeah, this is about the time we were talking about possible lightning in the area. And I'm saying, okay, guys, we only got 12 minutes. Let's go.
Yeah.
The last thing we needed was a delay.
Yeah.
Throw a screen on fourth down to Ryan Randall. I tell you, Ryan Randall, he's a very good football player. He decided to come out. He didn't play as a ninth grader. Came back out. He's just a 10th grader. He's a very good – he's going to help us down the road a lot.
Great vision.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he took that ball about sideline to sideline and got great yard gain out of that. So we're down there knocking on the door trying to get another 6 points. Give it to Bushong.
Good run by Bushong. He just runs over Romy. Poor old Romy gets run over in the back.
Romy got the block.
Yeah, he did.
He set the way, and then Bushung says, you know, the quickest way to the end zone is through Romy. So he goes into the end zone.
I'm going to check Romy's back Monday.
And well, maybe Bushung wanted to hit one more person before he got these six. I mean, that's just the kind of guy he is. Juan Palmeron getting the extra point.
Yep, Juan. And, you know, being left-footed, that gives us a little bit of a holding issue. You know, Thomas doesn't work with him very much. And
with McCracken snapping? Yeah.
And then Balin's our backup holder, and he usually holds for him, but it was a good job by Thomas. I think Coach Humphreys was really upset about his kid not catching that ball.
Oh, I mean, it almost died. Yeah. Well, we're going to recover it. Now, can you pick that up in advance, or is it just a recovery?
Just a recovery.
Well, we're going to have it inside the five if it stops rolling. Looked like a Phil Mickelson lob shot. I thought it was going to die on the one. All right, running play, and we got a running clock and a nice tackle by
Christian East again. Number 9 in there is Dusty Baker, who plays a lot at receiver for us. Number 17 is Zach Ruth.
That's my neighbor.
Senior.
He's in the game. I like it.
Ooh. 68 is another senior, Hunter Moss. And 77 is Eddie Guerrero, another senior.
They have a freshman quarterback in, Mr. Harris.
And that was a pick by Connor Akridge.
There you go. Read that well, stepped up in there and took the ball, was aggressive going after it. Got another quarterback.
Yep, we got Tanner Galman in the game, a 10th grader. Let's see here, we got Jacob Robinson at left guard, number 56. And we got a snap over
here. Well, we're going to work on that this week. Hey, shout out to Hunter Moss's dad. He sent me the text of the run-through for the banner for the Yellow Jacket girls, because I can't read it.
Yeah.
When we're at a wayside.
Yeah. Got Jess Ralston in there at running back, 10th grader. This is a good job by Tanner, throwing the ball to Luke Jones over the middle. Luke is a 10th grader.
Good poise.
Yep.
Three receivers right.
Give it to...
Well, we didn't.
No, Tanner made a poor read there. Should have given the ball, but
to Jess Ralston. Yep. He'll learn. All righty, they take over on downs. You know, after this game's over, you go back and look at the stats. They stopped us on downs 3 times.
They did.
Yeah. All righty. Freshman quarterback looking for that down and out. Good pass, good catch.
Mm-hmm. We saw this freshman kid at in the JV game Thursday.
Yes.
He was their JV quarterback.
Yes. Yeah, they're
We got Beck Fletcher at Mike right there, number 19, making a tackle. Jakeenan Dixon, 43. Zach McKenzie, 82. Thomas Ross is up there at 59 at defensive line. You got 26, Daylon Silvers down here at corner.
Jakeenan's not real tall, but he's got a big heart.
Yeah.
He's a good student who works
hard. He's the only person on the team I'm taller than. I tell him that all the time.
Yeah, but he's got a great attitude.
Yeah, he does.
He's always smiling. I like being around him. He does a good job. All right, a good down and out here on the right-hand side. And that play has been their favorite play all night, and we're winding down close to the end of this game. We're going to get the ball back one more time. Defense is going to come up with another stop. They're into our territory. They got a penalty against them. All right, ball spotted at our 48-yard line. Little motion. Quarterback fakes the sweep to the left.
That's a good job by Jonah Landry, number 99. He's a junior. 74 in there is Maddox Parrott. 10th grader. Let's see here. Here's Red Abernathy with the pick. I tell you, if he don't drop that ball, he's going a long way.
You're right. He's going to get a lot of coverage, a lot of distance down the field.
Red's another one that came back out as a 10th grader, didn't play as a 9th grader, and he's going to really help us down the road, too.
Yeah, good extension. He read the ball really well.
We got Brett Potts in there at quarterback.
We didn't give Brett much of a chance to do something with that first snap. We got him in a hole right away. I like the Southpaw quarterback. He's tough. Like the number 39.
Yeah. We throw a screen out here to Ryan on the 1 yard line, which, you know, we feel good about our screens anywhere on the field, even with our young kids.
Obviously,
you're on your one. We work them very hard.
You're on your 1 yard line.
This is Gage Giddens, who we high on. He's a freshman.
And he gets a run, and that's the end of the game. Yeah, Yellow Jackets are victorious 49-7. It's the first region game of the season, so you're 1-0. There's going to be four teams in the region 1-0 and four teams with an 0-1 record. You've got to set the tone, and overall, a productive night, correct?
Yeah, we're very pleased, but obviously there's a lot we can work on, which is good too. You know, we can show them the film and say, this is what we need to work on, and if we don't get any better at certain things, we're not going to make a deep run. So we know we got to get better in some areas, so we can do that. But we're sitting here talking about a 49-7 win, which is a good thing.
And your average score after a ball game right now is 35-9. So yeah. Things are moving in the right direction. We're going to take a timeout, and then we're going to come back and talk about the pipeline and some other things. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Welcome back to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And folks, we have your stingers of the game, the plays of the game. And Coach, I think we're going to do two offensive plays and one defensive play. Mm-hmm. You won a turnover battle tonight, and here's the first offensive play. First play of the game.
Yes, it is.
We could have used Cole Jackson's kickoff return, too. Kalen drops straight back. He's looking for the streak down the right-hand side. He finds Chaz Moss, and it's a touchdown after one play.
That was a good job by Kalen and up front. Blocking had plenty of time and a good route by Chaz on the post route and got behind the secondary for a touchdown.
Black shirts are going to run the tip drill. Keep an eye on number 13, your corner at the bottom of the screen.
This is his first defensive play of the game,
yes.
I think.
You're right.
Good job by Austin Bennett putting pressure on the receiver. I think he heard footsteps and Balin makes the pick.
Balin started off a corner. I don't know how he got that deep a drop. Here's our last stinger of the game. This is a nice little check down by Kalen.
This is a good job by Kalen. Route, the first two options were covered, and that's his third choice, and great job by Kalen and Aliko.
Yes, all the way down inside the red zone, and the most dangerous part of that play was Aliko had to get around the referee.
Yeah.
Referee was right there. We was right there to give him a hit. One thing I do want to mention before we talk about the pipeline and everything else, and fans, Coach isn't a real big fan of this, but I'm going to go ahead and mention it anyway. Since 2004, the football teams in the state of Georgia with the most victories, and you got to have 100. You know who the number two team is?
Who's that?
Calhoun. So now we're up to 130 since 2004. We're in second place for all the high schools in the state of Georgia. Congratulations. It speaks volumes about the effort by the coaching staff, the kids, and the community.
I agree.
All right. Pipeline.
Pipeline's good. We had two shutouts Thursday. We had a doubleheader at home. Our middle school team played Woodland out of Cartersville and won 27-0, and our JV played Gordon Central right after that and won 42-0. So I'd say those were pretty good Thursday afternoon.
Well, Thursday afternoon led into a pretty good Friday, so things are just going really, really well. That we're using the turf and we're getting our money's worth out of the turf, aren't we? Yeah, doing a good job. The came out of the game healthy.
Yeah, we're healthy. We got a little bit of pulled muscle here and there, but other than that, we're good. And, real fortunate to come out of that game healthy.
North Murray comes to town this coming Friday. It is?
Yes, Youth Night, which is an exciting night for our Calhoun Rec football programs. And Kim Townsend and them do a good job with our rec programs. And we're going to honor them Friday night with Youth Night. And then, don't know a whole lot about North Murray yet, but we'll watch some tape tomorrow and be ready to go. But we got to bounce back and get some things corrected. And, North Murray had a tough loss last night to Snorville, so they're going to come in here a little beat down, I guess. But they're a good football team, and Coach Gann does a good job with those guys, so we got to be ready to go.
You'll be ready to go. They're feeling a little bit happy with themselves because of the passing summer passing league that they have, so you'll be able to take care of things. We'd like to thank Coach Bill Long's audio and broadcasting crew, and the producer for today's show was Dean Evans. And don't forget, you can watch The Boys of Fall anytime you want, as many times as you want at YouTube. Go to CalhounTDClub.com and watch it as much as you want. You about ready to go to the house?
Yes, we are.
I think you're going to a football game on
Saturday. Yeah, I think I'm going to go see Air Force and Georgia State play in the Georgia Dome.
We'll get to see hopefully some of our kids.
Yep.
Thanks again, fans, for tuning in. You can watch it at CalhounTDClub.com. You've been watching The Coach Hal Lamb Show.